What is the purpose of a voltage divider? Hey guys! In this video, I will explain what is a voltage divider and how it works. A voltage divider is a simple electrical circuit used to reduce the voltage to a desired level. It consists of two resistors connected in series across a power supply. The input voltage is divided between these two resistors. The circuit diagram shows the voltage should be 4.5 volts. What if we require a voltage of 3 volts? In this case, we reduce the second resistor from 10 ohms to 5 ohms. Let's call the first resistor R1 and the second resistor R2. We will calculate the voltage across R1 by using the voltage divider formula. The output voltage of R1 is equal to the total voltage of the power supply times R1 divided by the total resistance R1 plus R2. If we plug in the numbers, the total voltage is 9 volts for the battery. R1 is 10 ohms. The total resistance is 10 ohms plus 5 ohms, or 15 ohms. The output voltage across R1 is 6 volts. Now let's do the same formula to calculate the output voltage of R2. The total voltage is 9 volts. R2 is 5 ohms. The total resistance is the same, 15 ohms. The output voltage across R2 is 3 volts. We can see the voltage divider works in this circuit. The 9-volt power supply has been reduced to a voltage of 3 volts in R2. In practice, we won't be using a 10-ohm resistor. The current flowing through the circuit is 600 milliamps. For most resistors, this current is too high. Excessive current passing through a resistor can cause it to overheat and potentially catch fire. To avoid damaging the circuit, we need to reduce the current. Since we still want a voltage of 3 volts, let's use the same ratio but multiply by 50. This gives us 500 ohms for R1 and 250 ohms for R2. Let's apply the voltage divider formula to confirm our calculation. When we plug in the numbers, replace R1 with 500 ohms and R2 with 250 ohms. The result is the same output voltage of 6 volts. If we check the output voltage going across R2, we find it equals to 3 volts. What is the current flowing in the circuit? It is based on Ohm's law, V equals IR. To calculate the current, it's V divided by R. The voltage of the battery is 9 volts. The resistance is the total of R1 and R2, or 750 ohms. The current flowing in the circuit is 0.02 amps, or 12 milliamps. As shown in this circuit diagram, the current flowing through the circuit is 12 milliamps. Let's check if we can verify the numbers with a multimeter. Here is a demonstration of a voltage divider with the help of a breadboard. Connect the red jumper wire to the positive end of the breadboard. Connect the black jumper wire to the negative end of the breadboard. Connect the other end of the red jumper wire to the red alligator clip. Connect the other end of the black jumper wire to the black alligator clip. We need to use a 500 ohm resistor for R1. I don't have a 500 ohm resistor, so I'm using one that's close to it. This one is a 470 ohm resistor. Insert the resistor in the breadboard. The left resistor wire should be in the same column as the positive end of the breadboard. We need to use a 250 ohm resistor for R2. I don't have a 250 ohm resistor, so I'm using one that's close to it. This one is a 220 ohm resistor. When you insert the resistor in the breadboard, make sure the right resistor wire is in the same column as the negative end of the breadboard. Connect the other end of the red alligator clip to the positive terminal of the battery. Connect the other end of the black alligator clip to the negative terminal of the battery. Now let's check the voltage that passes through R1. Touch the red probe to the left side of the resistor and the black probe to the right side of the resistor. The reading shows around 6 volts, which is what we expected. Let's check the voltage across R2. The reading shows slightly less than 3 volts. This is expected since we use a 220 ohm resistor instead of a 250 ohm resistor. If you use a 250 ohm resistor, you should get around 3 volts. The last demonstration is to check the current flowing in the circuit. On the multimeter, move the red probe from the voltage port to the milliamp port. Change the setting from checking voltage to current. Move R2 to a different row in the breadboard. We're going to be checking the current in series. Touch to the red probe to the right resistor wire of R1. Touch the black probe to the left resistor wire of R2. The reading shows around 13 milliamps, which is what we expected. If you enjoyed this explanation of what is a voltage divider, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring the bell icon to stay updated on my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.